We've seen cancer rates shoot up the moment the network of cell phone towers was established in the house. We had a coworker with us who had a son who was very, very sensitive to electromagnetic fields, and she lived here in Seattle, and he couldn't go to school because the schools at the time already had wireless installed in the schools, and he couldn't tolerate it. So she moved to Portland and then couldn't tolerate it there at all. Then moved over to Ashland, which claims itself to be one of the greenest cities in the world. And then when she Googled the cell phone towers next to the home that she had rented, she found that within 200 yards, she had over 90 cell phone installations that were broadcasting into her home, and her son was virtually going nuts. And then she moved out in the country, decided on homeschooling, and the boy has been doing well ever since. So after observing like some very sort of very clear-cut clinical situations where people were affected by the nearby cell phone tower, we became very meticulous in asking people about their homes and looking at the literature. I got certified in building biology, which is the sort of science in Germany that governs these issues, where we learn how to use different instruments to measure these phenomena in the house. And the first thing that we noticed is that the most important time in the day when we are vulnerable to the influence of incoming cell phone radiation is the nighttime, when the parasympathetic nervous system is active and the sympathetics are withdrawing. That's when the damage is done, most of the damage is done. And so we moved very quickly in telling all our patients a set of instructions. So our patients have to turn off all the fuses at night. That decreases a phenomenon called body voltage, and I think I don't have to go into that. It's probably explained in another part of the video. We have people have to get rid of their cordless phones, you know, because the cordless phones broadcast a signal 24 hours a day into the rooms wherever the person can walk and have reception. That is a very devastating radiation that was also tested in this Greek study that I just mentioned. It destroys the same number of proteins that the incoming cell phone radiation does from the outside, the cordless phone at home. So since 6 or 7 years, my patients are not allowed to have a cordless phone in the house. They have to go to Radio Shack, spend $25 for a corded phone, and that solves it. Then the last step that we do, that every patient gets to measure with the instrument from Gigahertz Solutions that we use, measure the density of microwave radiation in the bed location. You know, that's measured in microwatts per square meter. And if that number, for me, if the number is over 5, it's an unacceptable sleeping location. First of all, we look in the house. If you find a location, there's eddies, we call that. There's turbulences created in the house where often you find a location where the reading is low. If you don't, the person need to use protection in the house. And there's two ways of doing that. One is a wall paint that contains graphite fiber, carbon fiber, and conductive particles that creates a Faraday cage in the bedroom. It's a pitch black paint that's put over other paint, and over that you can paint normal paint, and then that paint itself has to be grounded with a wire into the earth. And the windows are covered with curtains that use a silver-coated cloth that reflects the incoming cell phone radiation to the outside. Now, with that in general, it's possible. Every place that we've looked at so far to bring the radiation down to the level where it's acceptable. Now, I want to roll this forward to the clinical picture. Half my practice is the treatment of autistic children. And we realized very quickly when we did this that there's two kinds of autistic kids, the ones that recover and the ones that don't recover. And the ones that recover are the ones that follow exactly this set of instructions. It is hardly done with the vitamins and with the other things that we do, with the behavioral therapies. They have a minor effect on it. The moment we protect the sleeping location of the child, the autistic children are recovering. Now, I can say that with great levels of certainty now for two reasons. One, because